what goes on is pole by pole, and then it's cross piece by cross piece, and plank by plank, and on we go.
Somewhere in there. I don't know. There's a few guys that are building them, but you know, they just want to do one or two and that's it. It's hard work. These piers have been around here for over 100 years. My dad used to build them. Like some of these places in here, there's nothing but rock for maybe 150 feet. And then you run into a sandbar, eh? And that's the idea, is to get over the rock into the sand, eh? And deep water. Okay, down, Bob. Yeah, hard. Harder. Harder. Keep going. Keep going. One more. The other side. Yeah, it's a dying thing, I'm afraid. My name is Don Skorupski. I've been doing this for 54 years.
Hi, my name's Rick Gill, and I'm one of the four pier builders in the village of Dunnottar.
Yeah, I guess that's what it is. Fun. Yeah.
They're very unique to our area, the village, Matlock, Ponemah, and Whytewold. And people come out, enjoy their coffee in the morning. When you hear the village, you think of the piers. Thank you. Okay, the piers that the village builds, the eight of them, basically are a good definition of the village. They define it in the sense that they've been around for so long that people would be very, very upset if something happens.
Two types of pier. This is a plank pier, eh? But then there's a boardwalk pier, which is right over there. And those sections are pre-made, eh? And they go up per section. They come here with the first guy that come here on the boat. There was no road here at one time, you know, and they come here on boat. It started to be, what my dad told me, it was for the high society people when it first opened up. They come on boats, and then of course when the trains start coming, well, it just started booming. Thank you.
plank wide. It's a lot of carrying and nailing and whatever.
Just a labor-intensive work of art, and as I say, they are very, very unique to this area. We certainly enjoy them. You don't have to join the gym when you're building these things, because you just work and work and work. Like it's just, as I say, labor, heavy on the labor of love.
Bottom line is, nobody really wants to do this anymore. I used to put up 27 of them in 1 year. Well, this guy is good. And the other young fellow there, he's a good worker and everything. And the other guy, well, he's a counselor, believe it or not. Healthy. I started when I was 15 years old. And my dad did them before me.
And then eventually we take it back to the village yard, keep it all together for next season. There'd be an uprising if they weren't up. Enjoy their coffee in the morning. People come out at night and watch the stars, any meteor showers. They're just a joy to have. They're good for swimming. A lot of people like to do the swimming off there.
I remember when I was a kid, 10, 11 years old, three trains used to come out at that time. Three of them on a Friday night. People everywhere. It's petering out. I don't think it's gonna last. There's just nobody that wants to do it. And Bob, he's a counselor here, and he's helping out. You know, if these piers never went up, they'd be on his
case, big time. Yeah. Yeah, a mini revolution, I think, but I don't know. You know, they want them, but nobody will build them. But maybe somebody will come along. I doubt it. Because this is my third year after I kind of quit that I've been back here trying to break in. A new crew every year. This is it. I'm done. Well, you know, it's a bit of an art, but it's once again, it's bulwark. You know, look at the bulwark.